The Duke and Duchess of Sussex took to their Sussex Royal Instagram page to make the announcement of the details of their trip, which is scheduled for in 2 weeks' time. The post read, "Today, we are excited to be able to announce details for the Duke and Duchess of Sussex's upcoming tour to Africa. In just 2 weeks, their Royal Highnesses will embark on this official tour focusing on community, grassroots leadership, women's and girls' rights, mental health, HIV/AIDS and the environment. This program has been many months in the making, and the Duke and Duchess are eager to focus their energies on the great work being done in Southern Africa. From meeting with Archbishop Desmond Tutu to joining Waves for Change on Monwabisi Beach, the South Africa program will be educational and inspiring. The Duke is especially proud to continue the legacy left by his mother with her work in Angola as he joins Halo Trust again in an effort to rid the world of landmines. HRH will also travel to Malawi where he will check in on the British Army's partnership with African Parks and will be working on the ground supporting local communities. The Duke is particularly proud to be able to deliver an exciting new initiative, a Queen's Commonwealth Canopy three-country partnership which he designed and consulted with governments in Namibia, Botswana, and Angola to protect forest and wildlife corridors around the Okavango Delta. The Duchess will be working with local organizations to promote women and girls' health and education, entrepreneurship, and leadership. With such a textured culture and history, their Royal Highnesses are grateful for the opportunity to connect with those on the ground in Southern Africa and to be inspired by the work being done and learn how they can be better supported. It added, as President and Vice President of the Queen's Commonwealth Trust and the Duke's role as Commonwealth Youth Ambassador, the Duke and Duchess cannot wait to meet with young leaders mobilizing change and adding to the beauty of these Commonwealth countries. The tour comes almost a year after their the Duke and Duchess first overseas tour, when Meghan and Harry traveled to Australia, Fiji, Tonga and New Zealand between Tuesday, October 16 and 31. They flew from London to Singapore and arrived to cheering crowds. Harry and Meghan Markle took part in 76 engagements over their 16-day trip to the Pacific region. The tour coincided with the Invictus Games in Sydney, which ran from October 20 to October 28. The sporting event, founded by Prince Harry and others in 2014, gives sick and injured service personnel and veterans the opportunity to compete in sports such as wheelchair basketball and sitting volleyball. After landing in Sydney, the couple traveled to Dubbo and Melbourne, before spending 3 days in Sydney from October 19 to 21 to mark the launch of the games and returning for the closing ceremony. Shortly before Archie was born, the pair also went on a short tour of Morocco. In February, arrived hand in hand and showed intimacy and tenderness towards each other throughout their 3-day trip. During the visit, the Duke of Sussex took time out of his exhausting schedule to express that more pressure should be put on big companies to end the manufacture of single-use plastic bottles. Prince Harry said not enough was being done to reduce the amount of plastic waste. Harry was pleased to meet Moroccan entrepreneurs who are tackling the country's social, economic, and environmental problems. The visit will serve as an opportunity for the Duke and Duchess to highlight many of the causes they have been involved with for many years, and also demonstrate a modern UK-Africa partnership in action. Throughout the tour, their Royal Highnesses as President and Vice President of the Queen's Commonwealth Trust, will meet young leaders working to address socio-economic and environmental challenges. Throughout this 10-day tour, the Duke and Duchess are pleased to raise awareness of the positive partnerships with the United Kingdom, particularly in advance of the UK-Africa Investment Summit in London in 2020. The first day of the tour will begin in a township in Cape Town where their Royal Highnesses will view a workshop that teaches children about their rights, self-awareness, and safety and which provides self-defense classes and female empowerment training to young girls in the community. Their Royal Highnesses will later tour the District 6 Museum to learn about their work to reunite members of the community forcibly relocated during the apartheid era. The Duke and Duchess will join a community cooking activity with former residents of District 6 at the nearby Homecoming Center. The following morning, their Royal Highnesses will travel to Monwabisi Beach to learn about the work of Waves for Change, an NGO which trains and supports local surf mentors to provide mental health services to young people. The Duke and Duchess will also see the work of the Lunchbox Fund, one of four charities to benefit from the generous donations made by the public on the occasion of the birth of their son Archie Mountbatten Windsor. The fund provides nearly 30,000 meals every day to Waves for Change programs and schools in South Africa's townships and rural areas. They will also meet Dr. Thomas Moss, who is leading the Commonwealth Litter Program launched at the London Commonwealth Summit in 2018, in support of the Commonwealth Blue Charter. The program funds research and action to tackle plastic waste in six Commonwealth countries, working with support from the South African Department of Environmental Affairs to tackle plastic waste and educate communities on the impact of microplastics in oceans. The Duke will then join the City of Cape Town Marine Unit to travel by boat to Seal Island, Cock Bay, to learn about the important role they play in combating the poaching of abalone, considered one of South Africa's most significant illegal wildlife trade concerns which have reached critical levels. The UK has been supporting South Africa's work in this area. As Captain General of the Royal Marines, His Royal Highness will be accompanied by two members of the Royal Marines who have been providing capacity building and skills training to the Marine Unit. In the afternoon, the Duke and Duchess will visit the Bokop area to mark Heritage Day, a celebration of the great diversity of cultures, beliefs, and traditions that make up the Rainbow Nation of South Africa. Their Royal Highnesses will visit Awal Mosque, the oldest mosque in the country, where they will meet representatives from different faith groups to hear about the strength of interfaith dialogue in Cape Town. Afterwards, the Duke and Duchess will visit local residents who will host them for a cup of tea in their home. Bokop was named a South African Heritage Protection Site earlier this year, ensuring that its unique characteristics are preserved for future generations. Their Royal Highnesses will conclude the day by attending a reception at the British High Commissioner's residence, where they will meet inspiring opinion formers and young future leaders, underlining the rich and diverse nature of the UK's modern partnership with South Africa. On day 3 of the visit, Wednesday, September 25th, the Duke and Duchess will meet Archbishop Desmond Tutu and Mrs. Tutu at their Legacy Foundation. The Duke last met Archbishop Tutu in 2015, when he presented him with an honor in recognition of his services to UK communities and international peace and reconciliation. From here, their Royal Highness's program will split. The Duke will travel onwards to Botswana while the Duchess remains in South Africa. On the afternoon of September 25th, the Duchess will visit the Woodstock Exchange to meet female entrepreneurs and investors working in technology. Her Royal Highness will highlight the benefits of networking between aspiring female entrepreneurs and successful female role models. The Duke will begin his working visit to Botswana on Thursday, September 26th, first traveling to Chobe Forest Tree Reserve, where he will join school children to plant trees and raise awareness of the fragility of these vital ecosystems. On Thursday, 26th, Her Royal Highness will take part in a private Women in Public Service breakfast at the High Commission in Cape Town. Women have played an important role in South Africa's socio-economic and political development. Invited guests have all played a key role in the development of South Africa's institutions, in parliament, government, education, and healthcare, and continue to advocate for women's rights and education, as well as gender equality. Meanwhile, on the October 1st, Her Royal Highness will attend a roundtable discussion with the Association of Commonwealth Universities in Johannesburg. The Duchess will meet academics and students to discuss the challenges faced by young women in accessing higher education. Her Royal Highness will then visit a school to learn about the work of a local charity, which receives UK aid funding for its work to raise awareness of and tackle sexual violence in schools. Following the Duke of Sussex's arrival from Malawi later that evening, Their Royal Highnesses will resume their joint program in Johannesburg. On the final day of their tour, Wednesday, October 2nd, Their Royal Highnesses will visit a township near Johannesburg where they will meet with inspiring local youth, entrepreneurs, and view skills initiatives addressing the rising unemployment challenge faced by young people in South Africa. Later that day, they will meet with Mrs. Graca Machel, widow of the late former President Mandela. The Duke last met with Mrs. Machel in South Africa in 2015. The Duke and Duchess will together attend an afternoon reception to celebrate the UK and South Africa's important business and investment relationship. Looking ahead to the Africa Investment Summit the UK will host in 2020. Their Royal Highnesses will meet representatives of the British and South African business communities, with a particular focus on entrepreneurs and the creative industries. To close the tour, Their Royal Highnesses will attend an audience with President Cyril Ramaphosa and his wife Dr. Tshepo Moseb. Their Royal Highnesses will depart for London that evening.